Students, now let us see what are the microorganisms which are not useful and which are not friendly for us. That means, let us learn about harmful microorganisms. Harmful means which are not friendly, which are dangerous, which causes disease. Okay, the microorganisms are harmful in many ways. Microorganisms are harmful in many ways. Some of these microorganisms can create the diseases in human beings, okay, in also in plants and also in animals. These disease causing microorganisms what we called as pathogens. Okay, the microorganisms which causes disease in our body are called as pathogens. Okay, some because of these microorganisms our food can be get spoiled, our clothing and our leather items can get spoiled. Now let us learn some deeply regarding microorganisms. Disease which causes microorganisms in humans. Now microorganisms, because of the microorganisms, there are two types of disease which can cause harmful. Some is communicable diseases, some is non-communicable diseases. Okay, pathogens that enter our body through them, pathogens can enter our body by many means of waste, by air or by water which we drink, and by the contaminated and spoiled food what we eat. They can also get transmitted by direct contact with any other person which is already infected or which is already diseased. Even these microorganisms can be transferred in the human beings by direct contact of animals. Direct contact of dirty animals, and the animals which usually be in the jungles, usually be in the dust areas and the contaminated areas. Okay, the healthier person, the healthy person can be get infected by the diseased person by through air or through water or through food or through physical contact in between them. Okay, these all diseases which can cause by communication with any other human being or animal or atmosphere or air or water are called as communicable diseases. Okay, examples of such diseases are cholera, common cold, chickenpox and tuberculosis. When a person suffering from common cold sneezes, fine droplets of moisture carrying thousands of viruses, and that all viruses will be spread out in the air. These viruses may enter the body of a healthy person while breathing or causing the infection. If some human being or animal is infected by some particular disease, okay, and during that disease, if we cough or if we sneeze, then there are thousands of viruses that get exhibited from his body during the through the small droplets. That droplets, if that person is with very close contact with any other person, then that droplets will catch to that person which is not infected, which is basically healthy. And even these droplets can enter into the air and can enter into the atmosphere. These virus may enter the body of a healthy person while breathing or can cause infection. So there are some insects and animals which act as a carriers of these diseases causing microbes. Very, very, very famous animal is bees and the mosquitoes. These bees sit and fly on the waste materials of the animals, waste materials of the human beings outside and surrounding our houses. These bees, what they do, they sit on the garbage and the animal waste. The pathogens that are attached to these bees come into direct contact with our food, with our utensils what we use daily, such as the water, such as the household elements. On these pathogens, which are harmful microorganisms, they transfer through the bees to our food and water. So these pathogens, by the source of the bees, come across our uncovered food which we are keeping in our houses, and they started transferring to that food. Whoever eats that contaminated food is likely to get sick. So likely to get disease. So it is advisable to always keep our foods, our eating utensils covered and avoid consuming uncovered items of food. Another example of carrier is the mosquitoes. And according to our syllabus, female Anopheles mosquito. This is a mosquito which is responsible for causing malaria, and malaria is caused by the microorganism by name Plasmodium. Okay, Plasmodium. Plasmodium is a microorganism which is very harmful to our body, and this Plasmodium is caused by the biting of the female Anopheles mosquito. And another type of mosquito which is also female, Aedes mosquito, A-E-D-E-S, Aedes mosquito. This act as a carrier for the dengue virus. Okay, what happens in the dengue virus? Our platelets get decreased, our white blood cells get decreased from our blood. As a result, we start weakness, we feel weakness, we go on becoming weak and weak and weak, and at final stage, we get dengue. So because of the biting of the female Aedes mosquito, these dengue disease can be caused. And all mosquitoes basically and literally breed in water. Breed in water means they all generate in water, they all take the burn in water, they all lay their eggs in water. Hence, one should not let the water to get collected anywhere in our surroundings, in our houses, etc. Anywhere in coolers, in tires, in flower pots, etc. etc. By keeping the surroundings clean and dry, we can prevent mosquitoes from breeding. Try to make a list of measures which help to prevent and avoid malaria and dengue such diseases. All the diseases which are caused by bees and mosquitoes. And now here is a table of the diseases which can be caused by microorganisms. Human diseases, that is the diseases which are affected on human, are tuberculosis. This disease is caused by bacteria. This bacteria can be transmitted through the air. Then the preventive measures is, we have to keep the patient in complete isolation. We have to keep the personal belongings of the patient away from those of the others. Vaccination to be given at suitable age. Along with tuberculosis, measles, chickenpox and polio. These are three diseases can be caused by viruses. And their mode of transmission is, these viruses can be affected through the air or contact with each other or through the water. Okay, these type of patients must be isolated at single room. They have to be, their belongings to be should be kept apart from all the belongings of the other healthy persons, and the vaccinations to be given at suitable age. Along with it, the cholera and typhoid. These are the diseases which are caused by bacteria. Okay, the mode of transmission is either food or water. And next is hepatitis A. This disease is caused by the virus, and the mode of transmission of this disease is water. When we drink cold water or cold drinks or unheated water or uncovered water or contaminated water, so these kind of waters can cause hepatitis A as a disease in humans. Okay, so what is the precaution? Main precaution is we have to drink boiled water and the water which is vaccinated. Next, last disease is malaria. This malaria disease is caused by the microorganism called as protozoa. Okay, thus one and only mode of transmission of this disease is mosquito. This malaria can be caused by biting of particular female mosquito, that is Anopheles mosquito. We have to use mosquito net and repellents, and also we have to spray insecticides around our, and we have to control the breeding of mosquitoes by not allowing the water to collect in our surroundings.